Hello, my name is Bo Poulsen. I live in Denmark. We are here at a typical Danish river, steep and narrow. We cannot wade in them, so we need to do all our casting from the bank. But when we have obstacles behind us and the wind is hauling downstream, we cannot use the overhead casts, and here we cannot go and make a snake roll due to the vegetation. We'll go stuck in that. We cannot use a double spey either. And a single spey, we cannot use that either, because if the wind is hauling downstream, then the hook will be blown into our body. So one day, I was playing around with the snake roll. But the snake roll, you cannot change direction with it, because the line gets tangled. There's a rule that it's called train tracks. So if your anchor is there in that direction, then your foil cast should be beside it, like train tracks. So I'm thinking about, well, you cannot cross them, so can you bend the rules, so to speak? So I imagine this roller coaster. So you're sitting on roller coasters going up and down. But in the corners, sliding over to the side, it's slanting. And here the tracks ain't crossing. So I'm thinking about transferring that to fly casting. So I've entered this landing roll cast. I'll show it and then I'll bring it up to you. Look like this. Very easy and the most stealthy cast there is. You could use it with floating lines, you use it with sinking lines, you use it a single hand rod, you use a double hand rod. The way you use it is you slowly raise the rod, tilting it onto the side so it's slanting. And from here, you pull it back so you get a more active D-loop, and then a forward cast, smooth power application, an early stop, and then you keep your rod there until the cast has unrolled. It looks like this. Easy. Show it one more time. Up here. From here, pull in faster to get more active D-loop. I can angle it even up to 80 degrees from an outfish situation. Show it here. All right, I need some a little more power. There you go. Got your 80 degrees of change with the slanting roll cast. Here I have a two-handed rod, it's a class 6, and I'm using a 16 grams line, and that's according to the FTMA system. Many people use two heavy lines, in my opinion. But here it's a Sinkfraw 3-4 Scandinavian shooting head, around 7 meters. Easy. In some of the rivers as wider in Denmark, I use a 14-15 foot rod, and I can cover a lot of situations with this cast.